Welcome to the most dramatic motorsports in the world. Welcome to the world's greatest drivers. Welcome to a global adventure. Welcome to the World Rally Championship.
You see, the thing is, this is motorsport's best kept secret. Or it was, because all of that's going to change. But you would have to move from where you're sitting now to watch the drama of each of the 14 rounds of this championship unfold.
To see people who are that skilled with a car, making it do ridiculous things, however good the cars are. Obviously, they've got four-wheel drive, they've got everything you can get. But nevertheless, they've taken it up a scale. And I must say, I do admire it and I enjoy it.
The things they have to deal with is an amazing journey of, I was going to use the word trust, but in actual fact, they are just pure mad. They're nuts to go over a brow not knowing whether there's a tree or another car in a hedge or whatever.
If you thought about the drops or the chance of hitting a tree or going off the edge, then you wouldn't drive as quickly. You've got to put that out of your mind.
I think first is the speed, you know, and to be exciting about driving fast.
The car is constantly floating. It's never really 100% in contact with the road.
On gravel, you can play, you can dance a little bit with the car. It's incredible.
It almost happens in slow motion when you're in there.
You're not thinking about what the car's doing. You're just at the limit of the car, and you're keeping yourself at the limit of the car the whole time. And that is, if you do that, you're going to be quickest.
The World Rally Championship is the ultimate driving experience. Held in 14 countries from Africa to South America, the teams will circle the globe, driving over 13,500 miles on the most demanding surfaces the world has to offer. Technology allows the cars to travel faster than ever before, but the extra speed, up to 140 miles an hour, requires increased driver skill and nerve. The championship's constructed to test the drivers in all conditions and on all surfaces, whether on snow where the banks keep the drivers on the roads, car wrecking gravel rallies, the altitude of the Andes, the speed of loose surfaces, or the punishment of European tarmac. Each offers a different combination of challenge, and this weekend in Monaco as a starter, the teams must deal with ice, snow and asphalt in the notorious mountains above the Riviera. Rallies, though, are as much about endurance as they are about driving skill, whether you're on the unpredictable roads of Monte Carlo or the red dirt of Australia. All rounds of the World Rally Championship run to the same format. Three full days, Friday, Saturday, Sunday, made up of timed special stages and road sections. So that's 1,400 kilometres of hardcore driving for the driver, 1,400 kilometres of precision navigation for the co-driver. This is the special stage. It could be 4 miles or it could be 40, but it's timed. And so fastest is best. The cars leave at 2-minute intervals. The fastest combined time over the 20 or so special stages wins. Other than in Kenya, the special stages are closed to public traffic. But when they get to the end of the special stage, all that changes. To get between the stages, the drivers use the public road, and like anybody else who uses the public road, you you have to go within the speed limit. If you go too fast, you could get pulled over by the police. If you go too slowly, you might not make it to the next stage on time.
Any problems they have out on the stages are fixed here. This is the service area, or the pits, if you like, in rallying. Four times a day, the cars come here to be serviced.
But only for 20 minutes. If they're here for too long, there are big time penalties added to the driver's overall time.
But once the mechanics have done their job and the cars leave to go back to the stages, only the driver and the co-driver are then allowed to touch the car.
Which means being expert fixers in everything and anything. There are actually two championships at stake in the World Rally Championship, the drivers' and the manufacturers' titles. It's 10 points for a win, down to one for a sixth place.
The best drivers in the world, Michael Schumacher, David Coulthard. Well, they're all very good at going round and round a tarmac circuit, but put them on a slippery surface like this, and I'm not sure I'd want to sit alongside them. But rally drivers absolutely love it, and the British are some of the very best.
Last year, Richard Burns, driving a Subaru, became world rally champion for the first time after being runner-up twice.
I jumped up and down on the car, I kissed the car, I hugged everybody that would accept a hug. It was just, you know, what else can you do? What else can you do? This is the moment that I've achieved what I've always wanted to achieve.
Until Burns won in 2001, Scott Colin McRae had been the only other British world champion, the youngest ever at 27, back in 1995.
You could say he's an English world champion. And I was a Scottish world champion, that's what we have to say now.
McRae's gun-ho style has made him the fans' favourite.
I'm quite a lucky driver. It comes very naturally to me. I don't really need to work at it very hard.
But his high-risk strategy has led to disappointments in the past, and at the final rally of 2001, when he had the world championship in his grasp, he lost his grip. This crash at the Rally of Great Britain handed the title to Burns, a percentage player and a driver, almost scientific in his approach.
Hang on, easy left line.
If you calculate how much risk you're going to have to take to be able to win.
Both Burns and McRae take risks. To win in this sport, you have to.
You can come very close to hitting a tree in sixth gear and you know it's going to hurt.
But with the risks come rewards.
Suits you, sir.
In 1999, Colin signed with Ford for $10 million over 2 years, and at 33, he's re-signed for another 2 years. But he earns more from one thing that has made him a bigger name than any other rally driver, his video game. Burns, 3 years McRae's junior, has secured a two-year, $12 million deal with Peugeot after a dramatic departure from Subaru, his 2001 title-winning team. Make no mistake, there is no love lost between these two. Each wants to be number one, and Colin in particular has enjoyed using any means to keep Richard as number two.
You trying to send Richard any psychological messages? What's the T-shirt all about?
This. I never even noticed I had that one. What's that all about?
Over the last 3 years in the championship, I've beaten Colin. So I don't think there's the issue there that suddenly I've become his equal or whatever. I think it was achieved a few years ago.
The third British driver is Alistair McRae, Colin's younger brother, a man hoping to mount his own bid on the championship.
The last few years have been quite frustrating. I've obviously wanted to get into the World Championship in a competitive car and prove that I can equal them and beat them. But there's more than just the two of them out there. There's a lot of World Championship class drivers there that you've got to beat as well. So it's just good to now hopefully have the opportunity to prove that.
Having signed for Mitsubishi, Alistair may now have the car to challenge the other Brits.
It always seems a bit easier psychologically to come from behind. That's what we're all going to be doing. And Richard's there in front of us, so you know, he's there to be knocked off.
actually seven manufacturers involved in the World Rally Championship. The Czech team Skoda, four British-based teams, Ford, Subaru, Mitsubishi and Hyundai, and two French teams, the Citroën and the current manufacturer's world champions, Peugeot, and their brand new driver, the World Rally Champion himself, Richard Burns.
Hi,
now,
Ben.
Richard, these road cars don't have an awful lot in common with the World Rally cars, do they?
They look similar, but that's about it.
So starting off with price, I want to buy myself a 206 World Rally car. What's it going to cost?
It'll cost you about £450,000.
As opposed to about...
About 10 or something,
10
yeah.
for a road car. Yeah. Crikey, 45 times more expensive. Now, what are you looking for in a World Rally car?
What am I looking for? Well, you need a good engine. I can show you the engine.
What sort of power is that engine going to give you?
This has got about 300 horsepower, a little bit more. It's got a hell of a lot of torque though, so that's
more than twice as much as a standard 206.
Yeah, three times more.
Acceleration in this?
0-16 is in about 4.5 seconds, something like that.
Now this isn't an ideal car really for pottering around town, is it?
No, you can get two people in it, but that's about all you can get. Even that's quite difficult with this roll cage, but it's pretty essential, obviously, not just for accidents, but to make sure the car's strong enough to cope with all the roads.
Now, it does seem to me that there are hardly any similarities between the two cars, but the biggest difference of all, and a lot of people don't realise, your Peugeot 206 World Rally car is four-wheel drive, and obviously the road cars are two-wheel drive.
Yeah, all the top rally cars are four-wheel drive. You need that kind of grip in all kinds of conditions, so it's absolutely essential.
And given all the impracticalities of this car, I still know, given the choice of the two, which one I'd rather go for.
Yeah, I imagine that you would have your eyes on this, but unfortunately,
yes.
Apart from the price, they only make about 45 of these a year,
uh-huh.
and they make 2.5 million of those, so I think you're more likely to find one of those.
Okay.
It's
a fair point.
The British drivers in this championship are right up there among the best, but there are about 15 or so other top drivers who are in with a shout, and you might fancy putting your money on one of them.
Four times world champion, Tommi Mäkinen. He's also a former Finnish ploughing champion, a legend in his native Finland and the only rally star with a hit single. 7 years with Mitsubishi, but now contracted to Subaru, he's happy in all conditions.
Petter Solberg, aka Hollywood, on account of his good looks. Both Norway and Subaru see him as the great young hope. On the podium twice last year, his fans think he can go all the way. He just needs time to improve on tarmac.
Colin McRae's teammate at Ford is Carlos Sainz, reputedly Spain's highest earning sports star and personal friends with the Spanish king. He's twice been crowned world champion and is fast and consistent on all surfaces.
Marcus Grönholm has a lot to prove at Peugeot with Richard Burns' arrival. 2000 champion and winner of three rallies at the back end of last season, he's a Finn on a mission. Once suspect on tarmac, he's now competitive across the board.
It's all very well sitting in this seat, but who'd want to sit there? After the break, we'll meet the men that do.
And Scandinavian flick to handbrake turn. Top tips from our rally school.
Wow.